Hello, my beautiful Scorpio friends. How are you today? Welcome to the channel. My name is Donna. This is Irish Donna Tarot, and we are here for a new love reading. I want to welcome all new visitors. Hope everyone's doing well. And let's jump into this reading and see what spirit messages you have for new love. Happy, happy. A card of joy. What's going on, Scorpio? These are oftentimes predictive readings, so they will not, sometimes may not even seem like you're reading, but they could be because time is a man-made construct. Imagine, okay, and the truth be told, one of my very favorite cards. So you're looking for the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth to find your happiness, and you are doing your affirmations and your visualizations for love. I love that energy for you, Scorpio. All right, so we are looking at the overall energy for our Scorpio friends in new love at this time. And that overall energy for the reading is the Three of Coins. Maybe somebody you work with will become a lover, new love interest, throwing caution to the winds. Oh, and Cancerian Queen, feeling your feels, being in this energy. You're highly intuitive, you're psychic. This is a card of the psychic. It can be Pisces, but it's also Cancerian energy. The High Priestess is a healer, is a person who's very discreet, very calm, but very, very psychic energy. Third eye is wide open. So that is your energy at this time in love. We have the Death card, Scorpio. There you are in your reading. Welcome, my friends. You have arrived. You are going through a period of deep transformation and following your star, your North Star, your inner healing. We have winner, winner, chicken dinner, Six of Wands, Leo energy. We have Seven of Cups. You're keeping your options open. You're very aware, Scorpio, that not all these choices that you could make in dating are going to be good choices, because we see a little coral snake here who's quite toxic. So you're keenly aware of that energy at this time. You want the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. The Ace of Swords, you want clarity. You know exactly what you want and what you don't want. We have you being very much willing to invest in a relationship. You're very generous, Scorpio. When a Scorpio is in love, look out, because you guys are just incredibly generous and kind, and you want someone who's going to reciprocate. You want someone who wants to invest. Oh, I love Libra energy here for you, Scorpio. It is virtually can be a marriage certificate. It can be a prenuptial agreement, but it can also be the paperwork. I always assign this sort of as a practical matter. It's the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. And it's also the seventh house of legal relationships, marriage, you know, buying a home together, renting a place together, moving in together with the appropriate paperwork that is involved in that process. So looks like you're coming into a period of time in which you may make a commitment. It's a very deep card of commitment. We have Nine of Pentacles. You are in this energy. You're single, ready to mingle. You are highly desirable. You are looking good, feeling good, smelling good. Ooh, Wheel of Fortune. You are about to meet somebody, Scorpio. Oh, and there you are in your own reading once again. Look at this. This is somebody from the past, somebody you may have known since childhood. You may not have been involved with them romantically, but this is someone who at least feels like home, somebody who's very loyal, somebody who wants to grow old with you, and you would like to grow old with them. Scorpio, I like this energy for you. All right. So the Three of Coins is the card of the architect who is there to help you build your relationship. It is the energy of teamwork and coupledom. It's the energy that speaks to the fact that there's you, there's the other person, and then there's the relationship. So you are definitely ready. You're ready to take advice, to listen, to be open to others. And we have after a period of feeling very disappointed. Somebody may come back from the past. Somebody with whom you would think would never show up again. They may be offering you an apology. That is oftentimes the apology card. Yep, we have look at you throwing caution to the winds, soulmate energy, two hearts beating as one. That's the energy you have right now that's all around you with this Wheel of Fortune energy. And a sense of wands, throwing caution to the winds, not letting yourself get overly emotional, being really tuned in, tapped into your emotions, and all that luxurious and beautiful nurturing energy you bring to a relationship. Page of Wands energy, Sagittarius. Maybe you are going to be in love with somebody who's a bit younger than you, or somebody who's very energetic. Could be also someone who has children. Look at this. Transformation taking place. Nine of Cups. That's a fairy godmother, the fairy godfather of the tarot. It's a wish is granted. Eat, drink, and be merry. It is living life to the fullest. It's a sense of community in your love life right now. Again, you're looking good. Nine of Pentacles energy. Cancer had the same energy. You're really on the precipice of getting that Ten of Pentacles, going to a legacy partnership. We have the Four of Cups. You want to have a victory in love. Right now, you are not going to accept a cup of love just for the purpose of passion. You will have a passionate new offer, but you are going to hold out so that you get somebody who is invested in the relationship. The Devil energy says that although you're a very passionate person, and although you have been very caught up in the past in the physical side of life, the Heart of Pentacles is going to prevail right now, and that is the Queen of Pentacles, Capricorn energy. You're looking for somebody who is serious enough to stay the course, somebody who definitely shares a belief system with you and wants a traditional relationship. That is a Taurus energy. It's your seventh house of love and partnership. The Seven of Cups energy says that though you want your ship to come in with a perfect mate with whom you can have adventures, someone with whom you can enjoy tiki torches, starry nights, that you understand that you must choose carefully, and you will do so. You've gone through a period of intense healing. You've done a lot of inner work, a lot of soul searching. Aquarius energy says that you are enlightened. You are ready for your person, and it looks like they are appearing. Could be an Aries energy. The Three of Cups, the truth of the matter is that you need a soulmate who is a best friend. You need someone with whom you can laugh with, someone with whom you can share a sense of family, community, Cancerian energy. Again, Six of Coins, somebody who's going to invest. We have a lot of repetitive or repeat cards here, a lot of repeat energies that are reinforcing exactly what you want right now, Scorpio. Two of Wands, it's time to make a decision so that you can get, you know, move forward into that more productive planning stage of your life. Not only having a partner, but choosing your partner with whom you can have what you desire. The Six of Coins energy says that you are certainly looking for, and you will manifest, the King of Pentacles. That's Daddy energy. You know, we have the King and Queen of Pentacles here right now. So both of you are very successful, very able to have a good life together. The King of Pentacles is that, you know, I'm that person who wants to buy you gifts. This person may have been a widower. It could have been somebody who's been alone and single for a long time. But at any rate, they've at least taken time in their lives to search for what they want. The Nine of Wands, they have fire in their belly. Your person's Sagittarius energy is really willing to go the distance. They will fight for the relationship. This person is a little possessive. I like it, though. They want to hold you close to them. This is a person who's not going to give their heart until they feel that there's some stability. It does look like they are recently out of another relationship. They've left something behind that was unfulfilling, possibly a relationship that was dishonest, or somebody who kept their options open. Yep, somebody who put them in a third-party situation. So we see that at this time, they are truly, you know, they're a bit in their head, but they are looking for their Empress, and their Empress is you, Scorpio. We have the Eight of Coins. Your person wants to get to know you. They want to get to know all about you. They're willing to do the work. Virgo energy, from Monday to Sunday, this person will show up whenever they say they will. Ace of Coins, a big offer is coming in for you from this person at the right time. The Ace of Coins is often the engagement ring when paired with the Three of Cups. And I saw the Three of Cups in here, I thought. We have the Nine of Cups there. Sometimes I lose track of where I put the cards. Three of Cups, there we go. Okay. So it shows that the choice that you make will be with someone who is likely to present you with a long-term committed relationship and invest. And the number three is a sign of the Trinity. So Spirit is very much. Spirit has your back here, Scorpio. Spirit has your back. Okay, why do we have the Virgo energy for our Scorpio friends in love at this time? The Spirit of Swords. So you are using your head. The Spirit of Swords is Aquarius energy. It's aloof energy. It's very intellectual energy of looking at everything, looking at the facts, and absolutely transcending and transforming a relationship. The only way you'll do that is through this period of transformation in which you don't just follow your heart, you don't just follow your passion, you use your intellect and you make sure that whatever decisions that you make have a chance to win, to allow you to have that win in love, to have someone who will commit to you. So let's see what we have here in terms of the Wheel of Fortune. What does the timing card have to say to us? Well, I was spilling cards all over there. Okay. So what do we have for the Wheel of Fortune? Five of Swords. Okay. So somebody has played head games. Somebody has wanted to win at all costs. And now you have this healing energy. The Five of Swords goes to the Six of Swords. You have moved away from that person. Liar pants on fire kind of energy. The Five of Swords, somebody who just didn't seem to know how to tell the truth. Again, an ending and a new beginning for you in which you're following your happiness and your bliss. Six of Cups energy here for you, Scorpio, Innocence of Pentacles. So an offer coming in, again, could be somebody younger for some of you or somebody that may have children, but it's a small offer. It's like, let's go out to coffee, let's go out to lunch. It might not be quite dinner yet. The Innocence of Swords, you might meet them through a dating site or through your, you know, Messenger, Instagram. It could be somebody who you've known from the past, who tracks you down and finds you. It can be someone that you've known from childhood who searches for you and finds you. We have the Ten of Wands. You are releasing your burdens. Absolutely great energy. The truth be told is that you are looking for your happiness and you're going to find it. The Sun card, Leo energy. Leo energy. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. You know, the energy of joy, of happiness. Happy, happy. Imagine. And the truth be told. So your happiness is going to be with somebody who's incredibly honest, who has your back. You have their back with that Six of Coins. Somebody who recognizes your value. And somebody who has also been on a spiritual journey. Scorpio, I'm so happy for you. This is a delightful reading. Sending you love from Chicago. Send some back. Tell me where you're from. I hope to see you in another reading soon, Scorpio. Be sure to check out the eclipse video at the end of this one to talk about the Taurus Scorpio eclipse access that's going on until 2023. It's going to be very helpful to you. So take care. See you soon, hopefully. Bye-bye.